of unbelievable things seem to happen down in Texas, and my recent elk hunt was no exception. But boy, was it a learning experience I'll never forget.
Well, what can I say? This hunt will go down as one of the most epic, up and down, longest, craziest, most chaotic hunts I've ever been on in my entire life. I've heard a lot of talk about people going after elk with air guns, but as far as I know, I've only seen or heard of people taking cows, females, with an air gun. And I've really wanted to go after a bull elk. And there's a couple states you can do it in, but I found out there was a spot in Texas through a connection that I had that you could go and hunt elk on open range in Texas.
I was sitting at the house one day and Lee Daggett, he calls me and he tells me that there's a few guys from American Airgunner that want to come down and hunt some elk with an airgun. And I sat there for a second and I told him, you know, I've elk hunted my whole life, but an airgun, I'm not 100% sure about it.
As airgunners, you know, we got to get inside, in most cases, 150 yards. If you're talking elk, an animal that big, I mean, I want to get inside 100, if not 75 yards to really get a good, solid shot on it.
Right over the top of it.
Yep.
Like, I don't know if you could have missed it any closer.
Okay. Well, and I put that, so it's like 3 1/4.
Mm-hmm.
Because I put that half just above. So we're good.
First day we go out, we're riding around, and we're glassing and we see a herd of elk right out of the gate. And Jonathan's like, let's get on them. He's like, the wind's right, this is right. And he's like, let's get on them. I'm like, what? I thought we were just gonna kind of look around and I was gonna learn more about this, and off we go.
I came down here, did a bunch of scouting, had everything, you know, kind of pinpointed down. And I'd had them in this ridge and this bottom for, you know, for a couple of weeks. And we get in there, and little did we know, it turns from a scouting trip to there's elk all around us.
We see the elk and we see some cows with it, but we know it's in the rut. Newt tells me that the elk won't leave the group that far, but he will leave the group if he thinks there's another female around that he's unaware of. So we decide to sneak down and around and then sit down in these cedars, and he's gonna call him in like a turkey call.
And we're probably 300 or 400 yards from this pond, and we see this bull elk come over the top of it. Rossi tells me, you know, we got to get within 100 yards of these elk, and I'm still, you know, kind of astounded at the fact that we've got to do this. It doesn't happen every day. We get up and we start moving, and Rossi thinks I'm absolutely insane for trying to get this close to this bull that had just come out of this bottom.
I mean, I've never been elk hunting. I've never seen this. I didn't know you could call an elk in like a turkey. And he starts doing it, and the elk starts bugling back.
We get set up. I hit one cow call, and this bull starts bugling like crazy. Before we could even turn around and get ready, I'm trying to range this thing. Rossi's trying to get ready. The bull comes out of the bottom. He's crashing through all these mesquite trees, and he just puts on a show.
All of a sudden, this giant elk comes barreling through the trees and just like, rawr, rawr, you know, like is there. My eyes go huge. My heart starts beating out of its chest. I try to range find it to see what my distance is, because now it's like inside of 50 yards.
What is it? 40.
It comes through the trees thinking there's some hot little mama over there waiting for him, boy. And then he sees us, he turns, and Newt goes, "Marr!" And that thing stops, just goes,
kill him.
I've been on a lot of hunts. I've been on a lot of big game hunts. My heart was beating 1,000 miles per hour. I wasn't sure exactly what my distance was. I just knew it was inside of 50. I thought it was around 35 or 40, could be a difference. I overthought it. I went up and I rushed and I missed.
It just kind of caught us off guard. You know, everything was going crazy. Adrenaline's rushing. We take a shot at him. I thought Rossi hit him. I really thought he hit him.
He turned like this and turned back at me. And I shot a little bit to, I mean, aiming here and end up missing right here, and it went under his chin and like hit part of his kind of bearded this area. Newt's fired up because he's called a dadgum elk inside of, into 30 yards, which I don't blame him. That was awesome. We throw a drone up to try to find the animal to see if it's laid down, and it is running like it hasn't been touched by anything. So we go back, look at the footage, and I shot right under its chin and it just hit that coat and the fur just pops up. And it's gone.
Yes, coming that close to an elk is unheard of. And that shot haunted me for weeks. But luckily for me, that wasn't the end of my elk story. And you can head over to AmericanAirGunner.com to see how the rest of this epic hunt played out.